few map changes. New premium tank is coming into the game with couple, let's say, controversial characteristics, and we are going to cover all that and even more in today's news episode. This is your friendly neighborhood Red Arrow on the thumbnail news anchor, coming at you once again with some juicy World of Tanks news. So, let's dive right into it. First map change is over here. The good old Erlenberg, the good old Turpenberg, call it how you want. This is going to be tuned just a bit. So this is the old position, what we can see, and they're going to remove one part of this broken house just to open up this area a bit more. Honestly, this part of the map was quite clustered, always traffic jam between teammates, you know, enemy team, just hull down, Fiesta over here, and this hopefully is going to open up the gameplay a bit over here. They are going to do slight changes near this position as well on the east side of the river. The house will be made slightly bigger and taller, maybe to protect, you know, the city guys from getting sniped from the hills, I guess so. And pay attention to this terrain as well, slightly lowered down on the top of that. Moving on, so this area is basically made... you know, this rubble was made a bit bigger to counter all the heavy tanks and all the hull-down tanks who are over there, just to give some hull-down action for the west part of the river as well, or the west side of the river. But you still, if you want to get over there, you're going to risk getting a couple shots into your side armor from all those guys. This is quite a problematic position, honestly. Maybe this is going to help it out a bit. And finally, they are going to help the north spawn out fighting the south bush, south attacking by adding a pile of rubble over here. So put any hull-down vehicle on any tier over there and you are able to hold them off like super annoying tanks, Chieftain of course, U79E, Super Kong, IS-7, 277 from tier 10s or E3 even, IS-3 in tier 8s, many other tanks, you know, hull-down tank. Put one hull-down tank over here and it definitely slows down the push from the south guys. South guys who are pushing in. So, those were all the changes to the Erlenberg. Let me know what you think about that. Do you want to see more? What would you change about this? Now, we have one more map to cover. It is Siegfried Line. But before we are going to do that, quick announcement. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, as I promised at the start of the month, there is going to be a giveaway in every single video I upload in October because we are celebrating 10 years of World of Tanks content on this channel. On October 13th, I uploaded my first ever episode about World of Tanks in 2011. It is crazy, time flies, I know, and we are celebrating it big time. So from today's video, you are able to win 25,000 gold. This month is absolutely crazy, I'm going all out, every single penny, not even a nickel from all the sponsored content I was able to bag for the month is going into my pocket. Everything goes back into you. Hosting giveaways over here on YouTube, on Twitch, on Instagram. We are going ham. So today's video has been sponsored as well, luckily for me. So let's hear a quick word from them and then I will let you know what you have to do. Mech Arena is a new third-person free-to-play mech shooter offering multiple fast-paced game modes, focusing on short but high-intensity team PvP matches. Whether you decide to play 5v5, 2v2 deathmatch or control point clash, you have to be ready for the changed conditions. Tons of different mechs to offer, featuring unique combat abilities and firepower, which you can upgrade and customize in various ways. You can make and paint your mechs as you please. Make a sniper for sniping like Paragon, which I really do like myself as well, or be stealthy as a ninja with Shadow, striking enemies from the behind, or build a tank to hold the line. Featuring different maps and game modes, you need to pimp up your arsenal accordingly, but this is where the fun begins, in my humble opinion. So jump in and start taking part of challenges, special events with amazing daily welcome rewards, Halloween events, and rank up higher by unlocking new weapons and skins, like this weapon here, which is part of the daily rewards. Use my link or QR code to get the Forest Digital skin, 208 coins and 10,000 credits to get yourself going, and most importantly, have fun. So here you go, and once again, thank you very much for helping me out to make all those giveaways, to host all those giveaways. Just, you know, I wanted to give something big back to the community, and this month has been absolutely crazy in that way. And we're going to give away some more gold in the upcoming months as well. Just stay tuned, guys. What you have to do is super simple. Just leave a comment under this video, together with your username, together with your server, and let me know what you think about all the topics we're going to cover in today's video. And of course, be a subscriber, because I would like to support people who support me. You have been supporting me throughout the 10 years, and I just wanted to give back to people who support me, right? Now, let's move on. Siegfried line, ladies and gentlemen, here are all the positions, what they're going to touch. Number 1, number 2, 3, 4, and 5 right over there. And let's move on. So, this is the old and new boom. One more bunker has been added. The terrain has been raised, so this definitely is going to help out the gameplay right over there. Extra bunker, extra protection, extra ground terrain changes, you know. Right over here, what is going to be changed is quite a lot, actually. Look at his house has been added. Just to protect, you know, in especially in the assault mode, to protect tanks who are trying to defend and come to defend their base, single base via here. Usually they are getting sniped left and right, you know, but this position will be tuned quite a lot. Also pay attention, a lot wider area to play on right over there. Bunker has been moved a bit, extra room, you know, just opens up this single position so much. Big changes on this map, honestly. Once again, a bit different angle for the same position, just extra room. This has been raised a bit as well, extra protection, you can see. Just copy paste some rocks right up there, and boom, we have new position. You know, higher cover right over here. Next position in the middle of the city, not too big of a change, but still it makes playing this part of the map way more comfortable, guys. Because, you know, this rubble over here all the time, you know, soap rocks and things, it was awkward over here, especially if you have a couple teammates next to you. But right over here, the rubble has been extended, better for hull down tanks, just to counter the other position up here, I guess, or that position up over there. So, some balancing reasons up here. And finally, boom, tree has been removed. This tree, what you were able to knock over. And for example, in Guerrilla 15, you were able to stay in this bush and you did not get spotted if you fired at all those guys over here before you fired. You didn't get spotted, you know, passively sitting over there. You got spotted only after you fired, but many times they didn't have time to react to you. So I guess they are just countering this, removing the tree over here, and that position is not as good anymore. One tree makes a position quite good, actually. So, map changes to the Siegfried line. Let me know what you think about that. But now, let's talk about the big topic today. Another premium tank coming into this game. Well, they do not officially say it is a premium tank, but many things scream premium tank, actually. The Tier 8 Chinese WZ114 heavy tank has been sent to the closed super nest, says Wargaming. The WZ114 is a heavy tank with strong frontal armor, low speed but excellent accuracy for a heavy tank. And under firepower, there are a couple more excellent things. Confront enemies head on, preferably supported by allies who do not allow mobile tanks to flank you or impose maneuverable battle tactics that favor them. Good accuracy opens up a relatively rare opportunity for heavy tanks to fight confidently at medium and long distances. So here is the firepower of WZ. Damage, 360 alpha damage, is nothing special. It is actually on the lower side. It is quite bad, let's say, no, this word of tanks. But 530 with high explosive. Usually, this would not matter. But this time, high explosive has 122mm of penetration. With new intuition skill, this can be very, very, very useful and, you know, game-changing in many situations. Standard penetration 208, premium heat 270, you know, as I said, like premium tank-ish numbers over here. But the main meme, of course, is that 122mm HE penetration. Reload time 12 seconds for 360 alpha is once again not anything good, but if you can tap that HE key, then it is pretty nice. Aiming time 3.6 seconds. What kind of sniping? What kind of quick sniping are they going to do with that? Not too many quick snipe shots, I would say so. But accuracy indeed is very good for a heavy tank. 0.33 stock accuracy, you can easily boost it under 0.3. So you can indeed hit some sniping shots, but the aiming time still is super questionable. Now, of course, it depends what the final gun stabilization numbers are. Maybe this is going to help it out a lot. Gun depression minus 10 degrees. This is a Chinese tank, guys, with minus 10 degrees of gun depression. This can't be a Chinese tank. Chinese tanks usually have like plus 55 degrees of gun depression, not minus 10. 20 degrees of gun elevation, so once again, quite uncharacteristical. Ammunition capacity, 55 shells. Well, you have plenty, right? Mobility, indeed, is poor. Very, very bad. 30 top speed, 10 moving backwards, 750 horsepower engine, 10.7 power to weight ratio. Oof. And now hull traverse speed 21, turret rotation speed 16. This is not a heavy tank, this is like a turreted tank destroyer. Mobility, oof, horrible, absolutely horrible. But survivability, 1,800 hit points on a tier 8 heavy tank. Usually they get 1,500, 1,550, 1,600 if they are lucky, but 1,800. Hull armor is quite heavily sloped, as you can see from the pictures, as you saw from the pictures, right? 125 in the front, 60 on the sides, 60 in the rear. Turret, 300 in the front, 175 on the sides, 95 in the rear. View range, 380 meters. Signal range, well, nobody cares about that, 720 meters. Crew, commander, gunner, loader, and driver. WZ-114, ladies and gentlemen. This thing doesn't move on the battlefield anywhere. It is not going to push the flanks fast, at least in nowadays fast-paced games. Oh boy. Survivability, definitely the bread and butter of this tank. HE, the bread and butter, accuracy, gun depression, all those things. But the mobility, oof. Guys, WZ-114, let me know what you think about that in the comment section as well down below, together with your username, together with your server, to take part of the giveaway. And soon I am going to pay out all the winners. And whoo, Wargaming, you just had your second Christmas, because this month we did so many giveaways. It's going to be expensive, and I believe I have to use a couple different accounts, because those will be locked sending out giveaways. You know, this happens almost all the time. It is to protect the accounts from potential scams or hacks, you know, this is how it works. But yeah, please take part. Once again, month is coming to an end, and once again I would like to say thank you for all the views, for all the follows. Hopefully I'm able to upload tomorrow as well to squeeze in another giveaway. We'll see. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, you have been absolutely sexylicious. Stay awesome, stay naked, take care, and bye.